The Rogue Trooper, a GI or genetic infantryman, a genetically engineered super soldier, blue-skinned and immune to almost all toxins and bioweapons known to New Earth. Highly resilient to acid, to the point of being able to fully submerge, unaffected, and the ability to survive in the vacuum of space with just his bare skin. The tales of the Rogue Trooper begin by following him and his three fallen comrades, Gunner, Helm, and Bagman. The GI program had an inbuilt feature that, at the time of their death, the GI's entire personality gets downloaded onto a biochip. These can be mounted for artificial intelligence in weaponry and equipment. The Rogue Trooper's comrades are mounted to his rifle, Gunner, his helmet, Helm, and his bag, Bagman. Forever with him and aiding him on his mission to find the traitor general that set in motion the events that led to the genocide of the GIs. The story itself has both similarities with the American Civil War and elements from World War I. Set on New Earth, a stalemate between the Noughts and the Southers, an endless war. As with all wars, they progress and the use of biological weapons were employed, destroying the planet and poisoning the planet's atmosphere and oceans. Being unbreathable and poisonous, both sides now living under atmospheric domes and military bases, the war became increasingly difficult to wage. The Southern High Command began the GI program in an attempt to finish the war once and for all, growing the infantrymen immune to the harsh conditions of New Earth and able to fight without the suits their enemies must wear. The Southern Command's plan was to deploy from space the entire GI regiment in the Quartz Zone. The intention was for it to be a surprise attack that could turn the tide of the war. However, a general, a traitor, in the Southern Command leaked the information out to the Noughts. The Noughts, now ready and waiting for the attack, deploy their elite infantry to ambush the intended assault. The entire GI regiment is wiped out all bar rogue. The GI, upon entry from space being prone to attack and essentially defenseless, are massacred. The attack becomes known as the Quartz Zone Massacre, and this sends Rogue AWOL, hunting and tracking down the traitor general. Though the Rogue Trooper is essentially immune to all known biological weapons and toxins, there are some exceptions to this. A plant, which is discovered after the GI's creation, this renders him unconscious but is not fatal. A retrovirus was engineered specifically to attack the Rogue's immune system, leaving him prone to all the New Earth hazards he was designed to be immune to. And later, when Rogue leaves New Earth and heads to Horst, he gets bitten. This causes him to pass out, though he is a super soldier, the GI were only designed to be immune to the toxins and hazards of New Earth. Always liked the Rogue Trooper storylines from 2000 AD and was overjoyed when they released the Rogue Trooper PS2 game in 2006. Personally, I thought it was a great representation to the character I loved so much growing up. Was it perfect? No, of course not. Every adaptation is not without its flaws, but they did a great job of bringing it to life. So had you heard of the Rogue Trooper before? 2000 AD always did a fantastic job playing off real-world scenarios and historical satire, and they did just that with the Rogue Trooper. Granted, this is just a small introduction to the character. I wanted to do some background setting before getting into some story runs, and hopefully, if you enjoyed this, you would pick up the comics I enjoyed so much. Personally, I would recommend the hardback compilations, as they are a great way to get involved without worrying about following a week-by-week thread. But as always, I'd be keen to hear your thoughts on the Rogue Trooper, if you've heard of him before, if he's a new character to you. Let me know your thoughts down below in the comment section. And if you want to see more Judge Dredd related videos, then please hit the subscribe button to stay notified of my videos. If you did enjoy this video, then please consider leaving a like, as it does help the channel out. You can find links to my social media in the description box below. I've been Mr. H, and until next time, I'll catch you in the comment section.